Hey there everyone, welcome to the YouTube video here on the channel. This is Rolling Stones. We're playing a scenario that comes with the new gameplay expansion for Arosa by Arrivet Games. Welcome to Arosa, one of the search and destroy some loaded FAC wagons signed to a shunting service. Where you'll take these wagons to the Aggregate terminal. From there you'll unload them and bring them back to Arosa. Finally, you'll finish off your shift by depositing the wagons in a siding and shunting wood wagons. We need to wait for him to move. Interesting that he turns his headlights off to shunt, but hey. It is what it is at this point. I happen to know, so this is my third attempt at this scenario, that this point work here is where I wish to stand. It'll be interesting to see if I've broken the scenario by doing that. There we go. And we can walk up to our train here. Got twinsies here though, unit 622 and unit loco 622 and loco 622. Just clocked that here for the first time. That may be an issue. Oh, that's interesting. So it comes onto different coaches and leaves its original coaches. Oh. Okay, oh, yeah, at least those for us to deal with. That's nice then. What I'm going to do, just as this is basically me driving, oh, come on, release. It's now. Power on, please, let's go. So we are basically going to come onto the back of these and, thingy. Good thing to note with this train is, okay, so when it changes ends, yeah, the, pan changes. That's good to know as well. It, with this loco, you've got the driving wheel, so basically I'm at 25 limits, so in theory, on 30 limits, so in theory I can do 25 comfortably. If I do 20, you see the throttle cuts out when I hit 20. So it's just one of those things to be aware of. Uh-oh, there's going to be a bump. Brace, brace. It's fine. So we're going to take the train forward now. To the Aggregate terminal. That's a bit of a biff. This is the god mode system, so I could probably do. But like reduce the cloudiness to cloudiness and yeah, just put it back to where it was. To note that if you press control and left arrow key, you do put your head out the cab window, which is quite handy just for sort of shunting around here. And yeah, being put. Whoa, there goes the Rosa 622. He's in the wrong cab. Boyo, change your cabs, mate. Right, anyway, we are going down. We are moving away here. We've got the green. Yeah, so you just sort of arrow key his way around. Because I'm going down a hill, I'm going to just pre-stage in about 60% of my braking application. And just to stop it running away with the train, basically. 35. So, we are, because we're afraid, we're going to be 30 through here. Oh, that was quite a lot of speed washing off there. Off just since I'm pushing the back of this, I'm just trying to stop it getting so much glare. So you're going to come around the curve here, and I'm going to put my brake on so I can get through for me, and I'm just going to start skipping the speed away. Conators, and you can see though how steep the hill is. Basically, this is a delivery that comes with the pack, partner in Japan since 1979. What a year 1979 was, am I right, oh viewers? So, double ambers, red next, so it's red ahead. What I'll actually do is I'll cheat a little bit. Do that. Which will then, yeah, should, oh no, it's That's a good, probably a good example of how to use that in a scenario. They want to set a red signal because I'm not cleared beyond that point, because I need to go beyond that point. But you also don't want it basically to force me to do some activity in the sim, which is a perfect way to get back to use Dispatch Beyond, in my opinion. So for those of you who don't know Dispatch Beyond, at the moment the dispatcher is not considering where my train will go after it stops in 17 minutes time. That might as well be the end of the scenario as far as the dispatcher is concerned. Due to the way that the train system world dispatcher works, there we go, so we've got the road into the siding. So what I'll do, okay, I just need to just go. I want to get out the cab. Wonderful. So just to secure the track, everything in emergency, just put the rest in neutral. Oh, that's cool. Didn't realize I could actually walk through here. Oh, hello. Thank you. You got the little engine room in here. You can get this far in it. Oh, this will be safety system controls up here. That's why it's got the colour crossbow, right? That safety system. Yoping. Jesus Christ, lads, yoping. Okay. This still isn't fixed. I'll be sad. I just wanted to know about that. Reverse it forward. Brakes are all off. Just use the... So basically the train rear static will kick in. The more speed it builds, or that builds, the more effective the rear static will be. So you will not know that I fucked it twice in a row. Do you think it's just pretty impressive? Not working on that. Gosh. Open the cargo doors. Okay, apparently we're just not dealing with... Like, this is just going to be heaped on the floor, which I'm fine with for that, but it just... Yeah. I've also not secured the train this time. Cargo doors open. Something tells me they should be going somewhere. Like, I like the fact there's a particle effect here. Is the amount of ballast in this thing going down at all? To see. No, it's not going down. It's apparently unloaded, man. So I will, full disclosure, say here, I think this is probably not supposed to go onto the ground. If it is, yikes, lads, yikes. But I'm willing to accept I've had another issue. Basically, I thought I updated the route. Apparently, it happens. So, yeah. But yeah, I'll probably verify off the game install at some point in the next 24 hours. I'm going to head back to Arosa, so what I'm actually going to do is sit in the cab and obviously power it all off. So master key goes off, headlights stay the way they are, zap. My phone up, please. Thank you. Go on, front pan. Key on in the cab. Nothing. Reverse it forward. My throttle. Oh, yeah, because I'm going to have full brake supply, aren't I, here? Oh, both pans down at the moment. That's always a fun concept. Pan up. There we go. So going up this hill, I'm just going to put 25 in. See, that's my start speed limit. Actually, my highest speed limit is 30. Well, the only I can aim for is 30. So pop that in. Have the train rocking and rolling up the hill. This is cool. I don't know why the train is still loaded. Like I said, I genuinely do not know if that is how it's supposed to be. I hope it's not. I really hope it's not. But it's revert, so I wouldn't be surprised if it was at this point. I do 35 a little bit actually, so I like the speed build to go dizzyingly fast. Can you imagine running this thing this fast? It'd be terrifying. Green. Pop 33 in the box. Green. I'm just going to hit acknowledge just to be safe. There we go, 30. As we approach into Arosa through the tunnel. Warned about a danger aspect here, I think. But, like, I should be cleared straight through into the platform, so. This is the first I've seen this kicking off as well. I genuinely do not understand what it's trying to say to me. But hey, anyway. That is this train thus far. Which is always fun. What I'll do is I've just got a 20 for entering into the station. We're stopping in the platform at Arosa, so give a wave to the other 622. He's in the back cab still, I don't know why. He mustn't like working for a living. So if this wagon, if this is jet, what I'll do, so whilst we coast in here, I'll bring the train to a stand, and when I've come to a stand, I'll pause the video, and we're going to have a look and see if the issue is what I thought it was. And so basically, I'm going to see if this is an issue with the sim or an issue with me. Hang on a second. Couple two vehicles. Okay, so these are being about. Okay, just left click to uncouple. Can live with that. Aggregate. Right. Is my road set to take me into that platform where I want to be? Yes, it is. So am I not doing the wood? Oh no, I will be. That'll be fun. Let's see how this goes. This is putting me in a platform. This is weird. It's a weird bit of gameplay design. We'll live with that. I'm just going to have a look at the Wikipedia fandom and just see if there's any screenshots at all that they've found that have the aggregate wagons with a load on. So what I'll do is I'll set my wheel to neutral and then press the parking button. That's fun, I can't. It wants me to set back. Okay. I'll do it from this cab just for simplicity today. Never mind, that's a go via, so I shouldn't actually. Oh no! No, that passenger train is still there, I think. Oh, am I running around my train to shunt it in? Fair enough, okay. I feel like I probably went a bit far going all the way into the shed, but I'll take it. Yeah, because you've got a crossover. Got the Steam product page open and I'm just looking at the screenshots that they shared just to see if there's any actually peeking into the wagons and showing them unloaded. The answer to that statement is no, there aren't. So yeah, it shows the unloading effect, it doesn't actually show the wagon unloaded. So I think I can figure out, I can piece together from that what has happened. Is that sufficient for you? Yep, perfect. Couple to two vehicles. Approach it at 10. I am rather tired today. It's been a long one, and I've got tomorrow off, and I'm really glad. I need a day off. That about summer. Okay, if I load last checkpoint, let's see what that does. Where does that put me? So there's a red signal. I've tabbed. Procedure signals indicate. Procedure signals indicate. So why can't I couple to that then? I'll see if just pulling forward slightly helps. Alright, it's just clipped. It's just pulled off for me. Okay, so if I pull forward, there's a yellow followed by an immediate red, so I think that's the red I have to tab. I'm actually going to be ready on that button, on that clicker. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 3, 2, 1, tab. Okay, so I'm loud onto him now. That's fine. Got a road set for us. I can now pull onto these guys. I think the red is after, behind these guys, so I need to make sure I stop and I hit when I buckle onto them, but hey. This is just weird at this point. Fun little thing to test. Pan down. Rheostatic braking doesn't work. Carry on. Pan up. It does work. Perfect. That was one of my things to test. So we'll just run forward. So basically what I was testing there was in some TS Classic trains, if you physically pan the train down in rheostatic brakes will still work, but the way rheostatic brakes work is by taking power, basically putting the engine in reverse and putting power back into the wires. If you're panned down, there's nowhere for that power to go. I've got to run around, am I running up? I've got to run around them, don't I? You know what, I'm just going to put these wagons in the siding and then I'm calling it a day. Because I think that's the main part of the gameplay I've done for this scenario. So, what are my overall thoughts on this scenario? Honestly, yeah, I think it's pretty cool. Overall, it is good, however, it doesn't feel like a tenner. A tenner feels... you know, if it was a loco pack, I would probably feel comfortable paying this much for it. I don't feel comfortable, you know, if it, you know, like, say if it had one of the other, narrow gauge locos they use in Switzerland, happy with that. But not the way it is done at the moment. It just feels like I'm being taken for a ride financially, basically. To be totally honest, it just feels a bit iffy. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to end the video here, guys. So thank you very much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit the like button. Subscribe to see more from me on a semi-regular basis. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, bye for now. That's not working for some reason, but...